Okay guys, on screen you can see a general question about range now. I just wanted to cover something up for you guys. Basically, from whatever I've done with range, I've always tried to use bows. Crossbows come into range at a very late estate of the range, like of your levels. So try and use bows as much as you can. They are very, very good, and they also do provide a lot more damage over crossbows. But obviously it depends what bolts you're using and what crossbows you are using too. But I'm sure you'll find that kind of balance of what you like to use rather than other things. But most of the time you will probably find yourself with crossbows. Crossbows have the better abilities, I would have said, like unload and that sort of thing. Those abilities are really, really nice. But bows are also really decent to use from lower levels. And throw-in weapons, are they good to use? They are decent to use, don't get me wrong guys, but I would rather use bows or crossbows. Throw-in weapons can be used on Slayer tasks. Things like Aberrant Spectres have a throw-in weapon weakness, but I wouldn't worry about that too much. I just go ahead and use a bow or a crossbow, just seeming as they have that sort of better damage and accuracy. But other than that guys, let's move on with the guide and we'll go and check out the armors that I have for you guys to see. So guys, let's start off with the armor that you're going to be wearing throughout your range career. From 1 to 99, you're going to need to wear a load of different armor. I'm not going to lie to you guys. So let's start off with what you should be wearing from 1 to 10. Be wary that also some of the armors that I'm showing on screen will have a defense level. And I will mention that defense level when it is so applicable. So let's start off with the first kind of range setup that you're going to use from 1 to 10. And this just includes a leather cowl, leather body, leather chaps, leather boots, and some leather van braces. You're also going to need a standard short bow and some arrows. Make sure that you're upgrading your bronze arrows as you go along. So for example, when you get to 10 range, you'll be able to use iron, then you'll be able to use steel, and the arrows or the bolts that you use actually depict your damage that you do. So the higher the damage, the more harder you're going to be hitting against your foe, whichever monster you choose to train on. So it's very, 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 very important that you upgrade as you go along. Even if it costs you more, you'll still be getting better kills per hour and better experience per hour. For standard, just use like an Amulet of Glory, Amulet of Glory, Fury, Power, any sort of amulet that you want. Amulet of Ranging, I don't even think has an actual range level requirement. So just go ahead and use an amulet that you can afford and use. And also try and get yourself either a Berserker Ring or an Archer's Ring. Just because the melee, the range crit bonus on that is really, really decent. It's actually going to help you out tons. So try and go and get yourself a ring too, guys, because it will be really, 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 really important to you throughout your ranged career. Also, what you want to do is if you can't get a ring, just get a ring of wealth, get whatever sort of ring you can. It's filling a slot, and if you have that ring of wealth there, you might be lucky enough to get a very, very valuable job. Also, auras and pocket slots. Now, obviously, I'll have to come across these a little bit later, but if you are a new member and you can afford sort of a ranging aura, or you can afford vampirism or penance, go ahead and buy those for your ranging career later on. If you can buy the sharpshooter aura, that actually, every time that you upgrade that aura, it actually helps out with your accuracy when you're using a bow or any sort of ranged weapon, so that's also very good. Other than that guys, I'm going to move on to 10 to 20 and I'll show you a good setup for 10 to 20. Alright guys, so let's talk about your 10 to 20 setup. Not much has changed, not going to lie to you, but at this point you can actually wear a hard leather body, which is actually going to upgrade some of your life bonus and some of your armor too, which is kind of a good thing to go and get your hands on. You can buy this from any range shop around RuneScape. Go to the one in Varrock, it's pretty cheap. I think it's like 200 coins tops, so it's a good thing to upgrade to. As you can see, not a lot more has changed, but I am now on iron arrows and an oak short bow. As for the cape guys, just wear a team cape from the lower levels. That will give you some sort of range crit bonus, which is actually really, really good. And then once we get on to sort of level 35 and onwards, we'll be talking about getting the Aver's Accumulator, which actually picks your arrows up for you, which can actually save you a lot of money, and I'll talk about that and the quest requirements and level requirements as we go along. So once I get to those levels, that will be up on screen. But other than that guys, that's going to be your 10 to 20 setup. I'll now move on to 20 to 30. Okay guys, so up on screen is your 20 to 30 range setup. Now as you guys can see, some of the armor has changed, but not a lot else has gone through the changing process. Now obviously you can still see that the amulet of glory and the berserker ring is still there. Obviously keep those, or keep an archer ring there and a power or a fury there. That will keep your range crit bonus up. We've changed over to steel arrows now because we can use them at level 20, and we've changed over to willow short bow because we can also use that at 20. And you can also now use the studded body, the coif, and the leather chaps. Now these are really good to move on to level 20, because the reason for this is because that you can actually yourself start to have like a better bonus when using ranged weapons and that sort of thing. So make sure you're upgrading your armor as you go along. But yeah, that's other than that, guys, that's completely it. We'll now move on to 30 to 40 armor. Okie dokie, so this is level 30 to 40 armor. You're going to be wearing the carapace stuff. Now this stuff is really, really nice, and surprisingly it looks really, really ugly, but sometimes it looks kind of cool. But you're going to have to wear it anyways, whether you like the look of it or not. I've actually moved the cape out now for an Ava's attractor, and that actually gives me a range crit of 1.4, which is really, really awesome. That actually requires the animal magnet quest, so go and do that one as soon as you possibly can, guys, and you have all the level requirements. It will save you a lot of money with your bolts and your arrows, that sort of thing. Other than that, guys, that's a really simple setup. Just go buy the full set and you'll start dealing you'll start being slightly more accurate, and you'll have more life bonus and armor, so you can take more hits. But other than that, guys, I'm going to move on to the 40 range setup and we will see what we can do there. So guys, this is going to be your general range equipment from 40 to 50. You can now actually exchange the carapace helm, boots, and the gloves for spined. This like armor type will actually give you a damage boost, so it's pretty decent to go and get. Unfortunately, on the GE, it's quite sought after and quite hard to get a hold of unless you put it overpriced. So obviously watch out for that, but it is very, very good all the way up until almost, I would say, 70, when you can get armadillo boots and gloves, which are even more expensive. But they're a good substitute to actually get some nice damage boost on your armor and weapons. Now from now on, after this the green dehide body, you have to do dragon slayer to wear the rest of the bodies, but obviously that's another quest that gives defense experience, so it might be quite a good idea to go and do it. But other than that, guys, a simple range setup is to actually go and grab yourself some addy arrows, sorry, not rune arrows, a U short bow, and basically just keep your setup the same. When you get to 50, you can also exchange out to an accumulator rather than the attractor, which also gives an extra range crit bonus, sorry. But other than that, guys, let's move on to the 50 to 60 setup. On screen, guys, you can see the 50 to 55 setup. This is blue dehide, basically a magic shortbow and some rune arrows. You can see that I've actually managed to switch up to the spined helm, the spined boots, and the spined gloves. Now obviously these require Fremenic trials, but they are really, really worth it. Obviously that extra damage boost is going to get you more experience per hour. Other than that, guys, it's a pretty simple setup. Change yourself over to the accumulator to get an extra 1.8 crit bonus, and other than that, guys, just continue to train up until 55 and we'll see what range setup we've got for you next. Okie dokie, guys, from 55 to 60 you're going to be using the same bow and everything like that. Just going to switch yourself over to that red dehide body and those chaps. Also keep the spined helm, gloves, and boots on just for that extra damage boost. But other than that, guys, it's a pretty simple setup. We'll move on to 60 now to 65. Okay, guys, this is for your 60 to 65 setup, a basic setup. You're just going to switch yourself over to that black dehide body and those chaps. Move over to the elder bow too for that extra accuracy and damage bonus. The rune arrows are still going to be cheap enough and that cheap alternative to keep you going. But other than that, guys, there's a pretty simple change over to the black dehide and black chaps. I'm now going to move on to the 65 to 70 setup. Okay, guys, this is your 65 to 70 setup. A pretty simple change. Just going to move over to that royal dehide body and chaps. Keep that spined helm, boots, and gloves on for the damage bonus. Elder shortbow stays and the rune arrows stay as that cheap alternative. Now going to move on to 70 to 75/80 and see what we can do there. Okay, guys, on screen you can see your level 70 to 80 range armor. Now obviously this is going to be the point when it's going to start to get slightly more expensive, so if you can't afford any of these armors, go back to royal dehide. If you can afford these armors, they are well worth your time. Armadillo has every single piece has a damage boost to it, and the whole set gives a sort of percentage of damage boost, I believe. Don't quote me on that at all, but I believe it does give some sort of decent damage boost. The weapons that you can use at this point a crystal bow, dark bow, or even Kirill's crossbow. You can either use the main hand crossbow and the offhand crossbow pistol variant of the Kirill's. Remember obviously that the Kirill's crossbow will require bolt racks, and if you're using the dark bow, use some dark arrows along with it to give yourself that extra damage boost. However, if you are slightly less, like slightly more poorer than, like, I guess, some other players, then you can go ahead and use Kirill's. That's still a decent armor. Remember to use your spined gloves and boots to give yourself that extra bit of a damage boost. And if you're feeling a little bit lucky, go ahead and put that spined helm on again, and that'll give you your extra damage boost, just like the armadillo pieces do. But other than that, guys, I'm now going to move on to the level 80 armor that you can use with range, and we'll see where we get there. On screen, guys, now you can see the 80 to 90/99 setup. This is full Pernix. Now, obviously, full Pernix is very, very expensive, and mainly for players who have already probably got 99. But if you do have the money there, it does provide some really, really nice damage bonuses and that sort of thing. At level 80, your weaponry that you want to choose is either going to be the Royal Crossbow or Chaotic Crossbows. It's entirely up to which one you choose or which one you choose to go after. If you're a bit of a Dungeoneerer, go after the Chaotic Crossbows. You've got some decent two-handed abilities that you can use. The Royal Crossbow, however, is pretty damn decent, to be honest. It doesn't really actually miss a lot. It is a really, really nice crossbow to use and easier to get than the Chaotic Crossbow offhand and mainhand. Anyway, guys, I'm going to move on to the sort of 85 to 99 setup now. I'll see you guys there. Okay, guys, from level 85, you can use the Death Lotus armor. Now, this armor is really, really decent for tanking main bosses like God Wars bosses. It can also be used in necks, I would believe. Try not to use it in the Zaris phase, though. But it is a very, very decent armor indeed. I'm getting up to around about 2,700 armor bonus. My armor itself actually gives 1,500, but my skill bonus gives 1,200, so a really nice armor to use at level 99 defense. You're gonna really, really benefit from whatever you use. The boots and the gloves can be switched out, but mainly this Death Lotus armor is for tanking bosses. But other than that, guys, Cyrenic and that sort of thing, I won't use any of those, or I won't put any of those on for the video because I just don't have the money to do it. But if you want to use them, go ahead and use them. They are awesome armors to use. I'm now going to move on to training spots and obviously XP per hour and that sort of thing, so I'll see you guys there. Okay, guys, so let's move on to training methods from 1 to 20. You're going to be doing chickens. Now, chickens are rather simple to find. You can find them in Lumbridge, so many different places. Just go and find a chicken spot, train up from 1 to 20. From this point, you kind of want to be just using your momentum, because your momentum is going to be better than just using abilities, and it's going to like be less click strenuous. So just go ahead and turn on your momentum and use that all the way up to 20. I'll now talk about the other training spot that I've got for you guys, which is spell wisps. Next up are the spell wisps. You can find these guys just outside the Wizard's Tower. I believe it's in a westerly direction, if not try the easterly direction, depends what however you are pointing your camera. These guys are really, really good from training from 20 to 30 range. They're really, really decent also to train with momentum on. However, abilities can be used, but because of your little number of abilities at this range level, you just want to be using momentum. Momentum will get you from 20 to 30 pretty damn quick. Once you've got to 20 to 30, you're going to ready yourself up for Dagon Highs, and I'm going to be talking about those in the next clip. Next up are Dagon Highs, and you're going to be doing these from 30 to 70 range. The reason this is such a big level gap itself is because it will go so fast. I reckon it will take you around about 2-3 hours, maybe 4, to go and get from level 30 to 70 range. These guys are incredibly quick with such low hit points, so you actually get really, really decent XP per hour. You can get around 287 experience per kill, which means a little bit for constitution and a little bit for your range. But however, you're going to be going through these levels so fast that you won't even notice that you've done it sometimes. I've used it on many different accounts, this training method, and it's actually really, really good. So once you have managed to get 30 range, go and gear up with the gear that I told you to. Once you get a 40, do the same and just switch over gears and keep switching over gears, and you will finally find yourself at the Dagon Highs, and actually getting some really decent range experience and constitution experience. If you've got any troubles with finding these guys, just find up a Chaos Tunnels guide or a Dagon High guide. They're plenty out there on the internet, and you should be able to find them pretty easily. But this is definitely one of the best range training methods that I've ever come across. From 70 to 99, you're going to be looking at many different monsters to train on. You can also include Slayer now to actually train your range, which will actually be a really nice and decent way to train it because you'll have a lot of variation. However, from now on, I'll only be explaining one or two monsters. Well, almost 6 or 7 monsters, but obviously if you choose to train from one way from 70 to 99, then it's going to be pretty boring for you. But you can intersect different monsters for different training experiences. Some are faster than others, but it could give you guys some variation when getting your 99 ranged. So let's start off firstly with Water Fiends. Water Fiends are really, really good for Crimson Charms, and also timed with the Charming Imp, you can actually get some really decent experience per hour. From this point onwards, you want to be using abilities from now on, because you'll have most of the abilities needed for the rest of your range career. It's really, really good to start using abilities now, just getting used to them for bossing and that sort of thing. But Water Fiends are incredible for their Crimson Charms and can also help you get that 99 summoning that you want. If you want to move on to Greater Demons, they've now had a upgraded drop table, which is actually really good, and they also do provide some really decent experience per hour, and they are just really, really nice to actually train on. So go ahead and check those out and see what you think of those two trainer methods. I'm now going to move on to some more trainer methods that will include 70 to 99. Okay guys, so your next two monsters that I would allow you to train on for 70 to 99 range is going to be the Black Demons and the Avances. The Black Demons have a nice Crimson Charm drop rate, and they also have an upgraded drop table, which could mean in some good cash per hour. They also do provide some decent range experience per hour. Avances are a really nice one to do too. Obviously, if you use a Armadillo item in God Wars, you can actually get some really nice experience rates without being attacked by the other monsters themselves. Be wary to take a Zamorak item too if you're going to go into the compound, and a Saradomin and Zamorak item if you're going to be outside killing them. They drop Adamant Bars, which are a really nice money maker. Hardy did a power hour recently and managed to get 1.2 mil per hour, and he's 99 range, so it's around about a mil an hour with some decent range training experience. So go check out that power hour if you haven't already seen it. But other than that, guys, it's going to be a really nice way to train your range up with the Avances or the Black Demons. I'm now going to move on to some other training methods that you can use. Okay, your next trainer method is going to be Red or Black Dragons. You can choose either one you want to, guys. Black Dragons actually drop the Black Dehide and Bones and are a good moneymaker, but however, they do also provide some really decent experience per hour, and so do the Red Dragons themselves. Both have really decent drops and some good green charm drops. It's entirely up to you if you want to use these as some sort of moneymaker. In the past, I've got around about a mil to 1.5 mil per hour at these guys without the use of porters. So if you want to use porters and make some good money, guys, these guys are going to be your best bet. Otherwise, guys, if you just want to power train, I wouldn't recommend these, as they do have a decent drop like the Bones and the Hides. I'd actually go to somewhere where you're not going to have to do too much picking up of drops, somewhere like Water Fiends with a Charming Imp, because the drops there are decent, but you can leave them on the floor if you want to. Okay guys, I'm going to move on to the next and final method that I would choose for training my range from 70 to 99, and I guess I'll see you guys there. Okay guys, the final training method that I would choose for you guys, and I would actually recommend it at a slightly higher level than 70, but at 70 you can do it, and this is Chinning in the Abyss. Now if you guys want to know how to chin in the abyss, go check out a guide. Basically all you need is a mini quest that requires which is with the Monk of Zamorak, but it's a quick quest, take about 2 minutes to do. Once you've done that, go and grab all of your chins, grab some good range armor like Armadillo or anything like that, and basically just find the spot which is best for you. That will be within the guide that I watched, so go and check that out. But other than that, guys, this is a really nice method to get to 99 range. It will cost you a lot, don't get me wrong, but it is very AFK, and you can pretty much like play Xbox or play whatever game you want to, kind of look over every so often. Sometimes you won't even actually lose any health at all, depends what kind of method you are using, what auras you're using, but other times you'll just have to take a little bit of food down there with you, but it is extremely AFK. But go check out a guide on that if you so wish, you'll see how good it really, really is. Anyways, guys, I'm going to now move on to the next part of my guide, and I shall see you there. So guys, this is a compact and comprehensive guide for you, and thank you very much for watching. If you enjoyed this guide, please leave a like and subscribe if you haven't already. There's some training locations and some armors in this guide. Obviously, I could have done a lot more. I could have done quests and everything like that, but I thought that was pretty obvious and people could go and check that out for themselves. Anyways, if you enjoyed this guide, please leave a like and comment down below, and also subscribe if you haven't already, and I shall see you guys next time. Have a great day, whatever you're doing, guys. Happy RuneScaping as always.